think it went out to the Discord. Pretty sure.
Waking up, sorry. Kind of slept in the snow.
So why isn't the bot showing it off on live streaming for the announcements? The announcer thing, or does it take some time?
It takes a bit.
Oh, really? It takes a bit? Okay, well, cool.
If it doesn't, then I'll do it.
Cool. Just be sure to show it. If it, yeah. Is it... Definitely
and
want
if
that.
People re about the ping, it's like I didn't know it was gonna ping or not.
Yep. I got my multimedia. Hey, hey, calm down, I'm streaming right now.
I'm sorry.
Let me just open up the screen and also open up the screen. Let's see here. Let's go to the
live once again, everyone. If you're watching this on YouTube, you know, hello to you from YouTube land. If you're not watching this on YouTube and it's live, well, you're probably not even in here yet. We got one person inside. We got one person watching. Or we just started up the stream.
Edit the streams into clips for like easy watching.
Yeah, actually, that would be a good idea. So then have like clip snippets of really good funny parts of like stuff that has happened during the stream, or just like highlight parts.
We can have the stream highlights videos, and then we can have the full streams just in case people want to watch the whole video.
Ah, see, there you go. That's a very good idea. We should do that for YouTube, actually. Rico Red, welcome! You are one of our viewers out of four now. There's four people here with us. This is going to be an amazing stream, you guys. Please always join the end of the month Friday streams because we show off all the cool content of news.
You love me! Mwah. Really love me!
Only a matter
of time.
Yes.
I know, I'm just waiting for it. At least I'm in desktop this time, I won't hurt me as much.
Yeah, but at desktop it messes up your camera.
Yeah, desktop it's not. Okay, yeah, it's not too bad. But they won't be able to do that for quite long because right when we start getting into it, we won't have this chat as we're showcasing out worlds and showcasing out items. But they can do whatever the chat can do whatever they want right now. It's of their choice because we're starting up our stream, you guys. Starting up for this cool new May 2020 showcase, showcasing out all the cool new content that's inside of Neos. And now talking about new content, we actually have brand new icons now on the UI. So let me render my UI real quick so you guys can see that. So you can see we got all these nice new fancy icons, which look quite great. They're still all not finished yet, and these are going to be like the visuals that will replace eventually the new facet system UI. Woo! Thanks for the zoop. But, you know, really cool looking icons, I think, so far, and I think that they match each button pretty nicely as to like what's doing on, and Coffee's the one that currently was working on the design for that, and they did a really good job on that so far. Let me bring my camera back.
Oh. Welcome back, Cam.
Hey. Can you not be looking like Telegram? On stream, shoot, boy.
What do you mean? I have permission to use these.
Yeah, no, I know, you're fine. In Neos yesterday, looking great. Oh, sweet. I'm glad you're liking it so far, Rico. Good to be having... We've been having the most people inside of Neos as of recently for these past couple months of hitting the range of around... Like, right now we have around 60 users online. And it's so awesome to get, exactly 60 users, and, you know, it's so awesome to see that user count grow, and it's going to grow even more once we get these new amazing updates, because everybody's friends are going to be coming inside if you're checking out the awesome new updates that are going to be inside Neos, and what it's going to mean for the future of virtual reality. So, yeah. I don't think it linked out there, Aegis. So you're going to have to do it manually.
I'm doing it right now.
Thanks, my dude. Just be sure to let everyone know that this is a community creations, community creator content.
Cool and great things. Yeah, it's, the community has made
it's our creator showcase for 2020 for May. And we do this at the end of the month of every Friday. If you guys are new here. So, yeah. That end, it probably is like a little bit off time from like the schedule of like when we start up the stream. So that's probably also why we don't have too many people coming, because they usually know that the stream starts at most of the time at 3, but we can start it off a little bit early today. Are you liking the beats? You're like, oh no. Don't put the camera on me. Right, Revy Lee, hello to you. Hello. Also, somebody says Darky. Is that one of your friends? Sweet. Yep, Darky's here chilling with us right now. Joris, hello there. Welcome. Welcome to the Neo Switch stream. Nice to have you here early. If you are here right now, you are here early. Very, very early. But that's okay, because we can still talk, chat, and have fun. Normally, we started the stream at 3, but I have enough energy to start the stream up early, which means that we can have this time to chat, talk, and talk about what we're going to be streaming about today. It's going to be a really good one, you guys. Sensation. Late at night over there, Joris? Sweet. It's right now 1:47 p.m. I live in Washington State.
All right. Let's close that. Turn on my controllers again. Yep. There we go. Hello, Rosillo.
What are the things flying around you, Aegis?
Wait, what do you mean the things flying around
you? I think somebody duplicated those things all around you. Sani Sensei, thank you so much for that tier 1 subscription. Very kind of you. Thank you, Sani.
I'm subscribing. Let me just get a mirror real quick so I can see what is going on. So let's see here. Oh.
Yep, I think they duplicated out some of your stuff.
I'll just do this.
Sunny says, well, it's been a bit incorrect how it's displayed there. Oh, well, yeah. Oh, and now we're getting some people coming inside here, which is good.
Yep, I did send out that thing.
So. Did you, you posted on the live stream for the, okay, cool, I need to hire. Cool, sweet. Thank you for that, Aegis. Everybody, let everyone know that, you know, we're starting out the stream. Bring in your friends. We can talk. We can hang out. And as well as show off all the cool content made out for this month of May 2020. Yes, Revy. Awoo. You know it. Corey, boy. Roselia says, I haven't been on for a long time. Well, you shouldn't check it out. Check out more of Neos, or, you know, just here, be here with us in the stream. It's kind of like you're in Neos in a way when you're able to, like, watch it. Oh. I think that got stuck. Oh, if you want to do those commands, I gotta spawn that out. They're Revy. Here, wait. Let me spawn out that item. There you go. Now you can do the Oz. And the popcorns. And the fan. Aw. Isn't that great?
Wow.
Wow. Yeah. My gosh. Hey. No grabbing the symbol either, boy. I'm joking. You're fine. We can even make it big.
Meow.
Yeah, then the particle explosion will be massive. Also, hey, Prowl Prime. Nice to have you here. Also, you typed in an extra E, so no, that just looks silly in chat. Oh, thank you for the cold breeze. Thanks, chat. Kind of you. Ah, nice and icy.
Hello, Leon.
Chili.
The like to speed.
Oh, you copy different Twitch description? Yeah, it shouldn't be that way. I guess somebody else typed in the extra E. Not I though. Definitely not me. Yeah, the fan is connected to the chat. Actually, you have Twitch chat commands if you read on the Neos channel. You should see all the Twitch chat commands that you can use on as a subscriber or a non-subscriber. But you can control those commands through Twitch chat inside the world. See, like right now, he just turned off the fan using the Twitch chat. And a bruh. Bruh! Can't believe it, bruh. Bruh.
You love me. You really love me.
Love you as well. I love you guys so much. You guys just don't realize how much I love you. Seriously. I really do. And we also got some performance here for you. We got this VR headset dancing. It's pretty great. The Crispy Muffin says, I have not a clue on how that works at all. It's using like an API, and it's connecting out through like our system through Logix inside of here to make it so then it performs through Twitch chat commands. So as the chat types in a command, that command will trigger an event inside of here. It's pretty cool. It's pretty next level. This is the future. Future of VR. Aww. So we're going to wait about like 10 more minutes, you guys. Just 10 more minutes, and we're going to be getting into talking about... and going through all the different cool creations and cool stuff that you guys have been making for this May of 2020. And I'm just like so impressed by the amount of content that's inside of here every single day. I come inside of here one day and then already somebody's made something completely brand new and completely unique. And I just can't wait to see once we start getting hundreds of new users that will come in and start working together with their minds to just build out even more incredible stuff. So the stuff already that we've gotten this May is pretty awesome, and we'll be getting in and talking into that about around 9 minutes, and just waiting for more people to come in so they can see the cool content that we got inside of here. Also, if you're brand new here, be sure to also follow the channel, because if you follow the channel, it helps us out quite a lot, and once we reach 1,000 followers, we're going to open up a merch store, and through that merch store, we're going to give out free merch. It's going to be completely free when we celebrate, so yes. And subscriptions help too. But yes, thank you for that follow, Miles. Thank you so much for that. Yep, simple as well. Yeah, free stuff. It's gonna be free Neos merch, maybe like a free Neos hat, free Neos shirt, whatever we can give out. But we're gonna be giving out some cool Neos merch to celebrate that we reached 8,000 followers. Thank you, Revy, for the follow as well. Thank you. We're getting up there. Heck yeah. You guys are awesome. Thumbs up. We can do that in VR as well. You don't have to worry about turning on your web camera and giving a thumbs up. You can just do it in VR. It's great. The Crispy Muffin, thank you for the follow as well. Thank you so much. Crispy Muffin also says, where did you guys learn to be able to make programs like Neos and such? I really want to make a hobby out of this stuff. Well, that would kind of be a question for Frox, because he's been working and developing out Neos's code and the engine for it for around, I'd say, 5 years, and he's been doing coding since he was, like, I think, like, 12 years old. So I think you have to be really dedicated out to being a person that is into doing coding and is able to do it for long periods of time, like Frox can. And but here's the thing that's nice is the platform that he's created out allows users to now create within Neos itself, and you can program within Neos. So you can actually create different games and different environments, which we're going to be showing that in about an hour or two once we get to the maze section of the world. There's already a user who has used content inside of Neos to build out a whole entire kind of like a dungeon crawler type game or a maze escape room kind of game. So it's really cool.
A lot of Fruxa's knowledge, a lot of the stuff that he's been learning and, like, work, a lot of it's self-taught.
So yeah, yeah.
It's pretty much kind of sums up.
Yeah, I would just say learn as much as you can online and be passionate about it. Have a lot of dedication and passion for it, and something that you really want to dive into more. You just gotta put the time in for it and practice. The Christmas says, I should take some time to learn how the UI and stuff works in this game. This is some Ready Player One stuff. Yeah. Kind of, yeah. I'd say so. I'd say it's even better than that, because it's like having the internet VR. It's like, it'd be whatever it wants to be.
It's not a dystopia.
Yeah, and it's not a dystopian world. Well, I mean, semi it is.
Well,
semi. Semi.
But in here it isn't.
Yeah. Also, Oriuri says, any way to export the different types of content that can be created in Neos? Yes, absolutely. You can take content that's within Neos, like let's say a mall that you've made using like the brush tool or whatever, and you can re-export that mall out using your file browser. And that's just on your belt UI under your tools. And then you just go to file browser. But yeah, like for example, if I was to create out like let's say a drawing inside of here, and I made like a really awesome 3D model drawing, you know, I can like start drawing out and make something. Right? So, and I could grab onto this model and save it if I really wanted to. But I don't want to, so I'm not gonna do that. Hey, I always have a fan. I got my fan on right now. My IRL fan and my VR fan. Chris says, by the way, I was kind of struggling to make an avatar, especially with materials, full body setup, and eye tracking. Well, if you need help with that, I don't mind after the stream helping out with setting up characters or setting up that sort of stuff, because I've set up at least 1,000 avatars here inside of Neos, and I'm sure it can be figured out, I promise you that. But when it comes to materials, I just grab the whole material from the root. There's also, if you go back on our previous streams, we actually have a thing where we teach how to actually extract materials, which we might actually make clips from that, considering that during these streams, we're actually going to have our video editor probably go through and take clips from the streams and actually post them as like snippets on the videos for YouTube. So then it's like easier to find it. So then it's not just all the whole content. So yeah. When you're so hot that you need both a real fan and a virtual fan. Yep. Cappy, hello! Welcome. Welcome, Cappy.
To answer what you said, Miles Sorotaro, one of the updates that Neos is currently being worked on is the UI overhaul.
Yes.
And that will definitely bring in or lower the bar of entry for users.
Yeah, absolutely. I think once we have this brand new UI in through here, it's going to make it so much better for new users and just being able to. So in about 2 more minutes, you guys, we're going to be going into it and getting into talking about the cool content of the new worlds that have been done out for May of 2020 for Neos. And we also have bigger fans now. way bigger fans.
The things that still need to be
Miles said, I've heard really excited to see more of the UI changes. Absolutely. We if you want to see, we have brand new UI icons that I just showed off right now. So you got some new icons that we got here. It's still using the old UI, but the new facet one is going to be coming in very soon, you guys. And we obviously have the new hand menu UI with the new icons for the hand menu, which I think look quite beautiful. I really like it, and it's a lot better than having to do the hand twist churn motion of how it was before. Now it's just like a quick and easy. You point, you click. Even my mom can do it. Seriously, yeah, she's more in it.
To answer your question, Rosilla, the further things that still needs to be done to the UI, Drux is working hard on the facet system, which will allow, kind of think about how Windows works, where you can like move programs around or shortcuts and that to different locations, see on your avatar or on your dash, and all the stuff that you need will be mostly on the dash by default at first. And be able to move them around. Like the voice options on the worlds menu there will be moved to the
dash. You want to get into the camera, Aegis?
Oh, yeah. The voice options will be moved to the dash. The scaling will be also moved to the dash in some cases too, if you'd like. Same like the laser enabled and even a locomotion. And then you'll be able to like customize it to like your hand menus or your avatar, say if you want like a quick
the whole amazing thing about the facet system, you guys, is it's gonna allow a modular UI that you can create whatever UI that you would like in the future. So once we have a really good base default one, you'll be able to take that base default one and transform it into like a dragon UI, a cybernetic UI, a cupcake UI. It doesn't matter, you can make it whatever you want because the whole parameters are gonna be made out and open for it. So that's why it's just in the same way that we can customize our avatars, we want to still be able to have that same customizability and same sort of level of detail with our UIs. And people will be able to, you know, create whatever they want and share it with others too.
I kind of want to make like a classic Windows 95-esque kind of style UI.
Sleeping, I have not mentioned the Cross Universe yet. I am just going through all of the different worlds that I feel are deserving and worthy of a showcase for here for our community showcase for May of 2020. But if you want to let them know and let them know that we're streaming and talking about Cross Universe right now, we're going to be talking about it in probably right now. So
we are in the world currently.
So let them know. Also, please try Sky. I know you love scale and stuff, but try to be calm. Okay, so obviously we're inside of this really awesome world. Let me move out the stuff that doesn't belong here though, and I'll switch it over to my first person perspective. So right when you spawn into the world, you spawn into the center, and obviously the Twitch chat isn't here like when you first spawn in through the world, but you have all the rules right here. I believe that these are the rules, but I think that they're inside of Japanese, which is fine, because I believe that they're also working on English versions as well, such as making out now that they have English cards, and as well as I think that there is an English rulebook that I'm pretty sure is inside of the folder. Also, Dark, thank you so much for the follow as well. Very kind of you. And you can see that there is public here for, and the name of this world, just so that you guys know, is Cross Universe, and it's been done out by the Neos East Japan team. And those are the people that basically are helping the Japanese users here inside of Neos, who are that speak mostly Japanese, so then they can understand how to use Neos. And if you guys want, we actually have this Cross Universe folder now inside of the games under Neos Essential, Cross Universe Public, and you can have access to this. And if you are an English speaker, you can just double click, go to English, and then there's a whole bunch of different English decks, so then you can learn how to play this game. And I'll actually be showing the tables and the cards here in a second, so then you guys can see what exactly this is about. It's similar to like a game kind of like Yu-Gi-Oh! Or Hearthstone or Magic the Gathering, kind of like games like that. But it's being done out in VR, which is really quite awesome, to say the least. So We'll actually go over here and show off some of the cool different card makers that you can actually have in here. So right over here. Also, Vika, thank you so much for the follow. Also, Mr. H3, thank you for the follow as well. So right here we have the card creator. Now what this allows you to do is you can make whatever card that you would like, place the model right here that you would want, and then you'd click this button and it registers the card. So then whenever you put down the card, it makes a model appear out of it. So you see that? And you can do this with whatever cards that you would like. So you can see that this card has like this visual right here. It's a level 1 card. And I can place it down and it's going to have that effect of that creature. There's the rule written back in English and Japanese. Oh, perfect. Thank you, Sleeping. So they did some very, very cool effects so far, I would say, on these cards. And you can obviously come inside of here and create your own different effects that you might have for cards that you might see inside of here. So if you see one that hasn't been created yet, you know.
Wonder if this one was.
Yeah, try it out. Yep.
Oh.
Each one of these, I think, does an effect. This is also one a card that destroys the whole field, I believe. So it's just this giant black hole. Also, TriSky, thank you as well for the Twitch follow, which they're inside of here with us. Thanks, my dude.
And a big explosion. The sun. Yes.
Yeah. Christy says, dude, my brain is overloading. I have no clue how this was made, and I really want to make this. Yeah.
Ooh, like the lightning they did on this one.
Oh, yeah. So what this card does is, if you discard, I believe it's if you discard a certain amount of cards and there's 3 enemies that are attacking you, you can wipe off the whole board with this card.
Ooh.
Yeah, this one is really cool because it actually has the dragon animation effect.
Like a serpentine dragon. Oh, yeah, it's actually more or less like a snake.
Yeah, it's like
a fire snake.
Yeah, it's like a fire snake. Look at that, you guys. Isn't that sick? And
what was the card shuffle one? Because I kind of like that.
And they have all of the cards right here. And again, currently, a lot of these cards have already been translated out to English, and we'll be showing the English cards. But right now, all of these are all of the Japanese cards, and you can select them based by their level. So this would be level 0 all the way down to level 10. And these are all the unit cards, the spell cards, and the item cards. And you can, you know, see going through. And you can actually, if you want to choose a card, so like, let's say if I want to choose this card, I can click on it, and now I can grab it and add it to my deck. So, there we go.
Brick token?
Yeah, the brick token. You're right.
Lego.
Yeah, the Lego one. Lego card. I love it. So this is Cross Universe, and this has been brought inside of Neos, and thankfully the creator of Cross Universe has said that it's fine that we have it inside of here, which is so awesome, and I'm glad that they are, you know, bringing it here and sharing their creativity here inside of Neos. And I think that the community has been loving using this, not only just the Japanese community, which has been coming inside of here a lot playing this game, but also the English-speaking community now, because they now have been making out the English cards to be translated. So if you guys like card games, this is really, really fun and awesome, and I would highly suggest to for you guys to like learn how to play, which we're going to be showing the board as well that they got set up over here. And this, all of the worlds that we're showing off today are completely featured worlds. And if you ever want to find a featured world, it's going to be under your worlds tab, under browse worlds. And then you're just going to click on the left hand corner and you're going to select featured. So let me actually show my worlds so you can see. So you're just going to go to the left hand side, click on featured, and then you're going to see from Cross Universe all the way up for all the worlds that we're going to be showcasing for the month. Yeah, and Sleeping says even the creator of Cross Universe is playing in Neos VR, which is freaking so cool. I love that. And yeah, I met him just the other day, and he seems like an awesome person. So right here, Sleeping, what was his name again? I'm pretty sure Sleeping knows their name. But with this table that we got right here, so think of it this way, the whole premise of the game is it's a 1v1 card game, and each person and each player has 1,000 life points, right? So we each have 1,000 life points, and then we can place our decks right here. So if I had my deck, let me spawn out just like a basic one. So I'll go to the Cross Universe public folder, go to the English, we'll just select the starter or basic decks. Yeah, we'll just go basic decks. So his name is Espera. Which sounds kind of cool. And then, so I'm going to, so when you're putting the deck inside of the card slot, you're just going to place the corner right there. And it's going to just automatically snap into place. And then you can see what each card that you've chosen. So you can see they're in English now. And you can actually swap these cards between Japanese and English from Will. So if I wanted to switch like this card right here to Japanese, I can just click on this one right here. Now it's Japanese. And now, let me show my lasers so you guys can see my lasers. So here's my laser right here. And I'm switching it to English, to Japanese, to English. So that way, if you're playing with another Japanese user, they would be able to swap them and see them in either way. A cool premise about this game is these would be unicards. So usually you can tell the difference between a spell card or an item card or unicard based on their attack and their defense. So we have these would all be unicards right here because they have an attack and defense. And these would be spell cards right up here. And they'll say right down here, standard spell. So like this one, target a unit on the field to cast during this turn. It gets 0 and 100 health, and this costs 0 mana. And that's another thing about this game is that you start off with 5 mana in the beginning of your turn, and you're spending that mana depending on how much cards that are being used. It's quite a complex game, but once you learn it, it can be really fun once both players get into it, and you can close down your deck, and you can also draw cards as well. But remember, with this game, it is always good to like start off with a commander. And for this deck specifically, it'd probably be a good idea to start off with this one as your commander card. And commander cards, they're just left on the board on the field for the rest of the game. And basically are the things that attack you. And if you start losing life points, you go right over here and you would reduce down your points. So let's say if I was to attack him, his life points would be going down and more 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 and more. And now he's dead. Yes, melt. But yeah, so really an awesome game, and I would highly recommend if you guys ever want to like learn how to play. I won't go through all the steps or the process of strategy on how to play out this game, but if you ever do and see me on inside of here, I can definitely show you how to play. It's a really cool game, and I'm glad to have it here inside of Neos. Oh wow, Snooper, thank you so much for all those gifted subs. Snooper just gave 10 gifted subs. Very, very kind of you, man. So nice of you. Everyone who got a gifted sub, be sure to thank them. Yes, Poggers indeed. You see all those gifted subs are just conglomerating on Aegis. They're just like, thank you, Aegis, thank you. Yes, hearts to you as well, Snooper. Thank you so much for that. Yep, you joined a sub bomb. Nice! Sounds awesome, Snooper. Glad you're getting your index. And Aegis is getting love now, too. So hopefully you guys like that so far, and that was our first thing to show off kind of for this month of May.
Month of May.
Yes. And we can also come back in here in a little bit. But if ever you want to find this, it's going to be inside of the now Neos Essentials Under Games for a cross-universe public. And then you can spawn out the board whenever you'd like. The board for the... Oh, the subs are... all over the place. Thank you again for that, Snooper. you can spawn out the board of the game just right from here, and you just double click on to spawn out stuff. I set Nyx in attack mode and Aegis in defense mode. Okay.
That's pretty much me. Shield.
Yeah, if we have some extra time, we'll actually play through a whole entire game, which I think would be fun. But I do want to be sure that we show off all the cool content and all the cool things of this month, so. Oh my gosh. All the subs. Ah! Ah! The subs, they're chasing me. They're actually chasing me. There's a rule written behind the sign. Let me see. Yes. Okay, perfect. I see where they're at. So if you click on this button right here, there's also videos as well. And also, I believe, Japanese tutorials on how to play. Will says, hello, Neosphere, how are you? I am doing awesome. Nice to have you. Oh no, don't start playing them all at the same time, are you kidding me? Really? sorry to hear about that, Mistral. Oh, you're working on the English one as well, Sleeping Kai Kai? Awesome. So I'm guessing that they'll probably have the English version here as well. For how to learn how to play. So once that's up, then you guys can like learn. But when it's like this, yeah, don't get overwhelmed. Sheesh, are you kidding me? Like, you're playing them all at once. But yeah, I think you guys would definitely love this game, and it's so cool to actually be able to play it here inside of VR, and it feels like you're really playing across from somebody. So if you enjoyed card games back when you were like a little kid, this is like kind of like going back into it and being able to do it in virtual reality and still be able to play together, which that's the awesome thing about VR. HSF says, would love to show up in person and see how you guys are doing, but I've just hit a roadblock. I now need to figure out how to deal with my IPv6 subnetting. So come writing my network protocol, I can do it without causing packet glitch problems with my head. Understandable. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Here. You can have the pizza, my dude. Oh, nice. I gotta have all the dragon cards, all of them. Haha. Yeah, I know. Okay, so we're gonna be going now to the other worlds, you guys. The next world that we're going to be showing off for this communicate. This is not Yu-Gi-Oh! This is Cross Universe, and this is a world made out by the Neos East Japan. And yeah, it's a really cool world, and they're now finally translating it out for English, so then English speakers can also play. And it's all in Japanese as well, if you can read Japanese too. And yeah, it's a really cool thing, and it's definitely an awesome world to be able to showcase out here in 7EOS. So the next one that we're going to be going to, you guys, is going to be Pirate Island. This one was done out by Enverex. Thanks for the hat. And again, like I said, if we have time during the stream and we make good time for showing off all the worlds, then we can come back here and also play a game. But I do want to be able to show off the awesome thing that we got going at the end. Oh, thanks for the pizza, my dude. Okay, so I'm gonna start a new session. We're here, you guys. Also, inside of Neos, you don't wait to load into a world. You just immediately end up inside the world, and then it loads around you. At least as of right now. but the reason why we have it that way is because once optimizations go through, worlds will load up even quicker, so it won't really matter to have a loading screen. And now the world's basically fully loaded.
Can create like a loading space that, say they spawn in a larger world, they can create like, say, like a loading area if they like.
Yeah. And a nice thing about loading inside of a world beforehand is that you can actually still talk to people while they're loading, and you're not having to wait for that person in through this loading screen mechanic. It's kind of annoying, and having something like it to where you can just talk to a person immediately right when you join in, I don't mind waiting for the textures to load in if I can still talk to my friends.
And you can like switch back to another world while you're loading this one, so while you load this one, you'll be in another world talking with someone else.
Yeah, if I really want to, I can just swap worlds back to like the cross-universe world real quick and then just swap back to this one immediately and just like, you know, wait for the other world to load and I'll be inside of this one and then, blink, go back into the side of this one. Remember, everyone, we can blink. Bink, 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 bink. Can we set a loading method, though? I would love to be able to load a world like The Matrix. Yeah, actually, that would be a really cool idea, like, have your own local effect for loading worlds. That would be cool. I like that idea. Yes, you can do that with worlds, Mr. L. You can swap between them. Very quickly and easily. Yep. Also do that. Check out the Mr. C. So obviously we have this really cool, beautiful world here that was made out by Enverex. It's kind of like a pirate ship type world.
Hello.
Very naturey, very calming, right? Do you feel like you're in the tropical beach, Try? Cool. Here, let's actually give you a drink, my dude. Some nice... there you go. Careful, it's a... high percentile. Oh no. Sam says, the world loading is one of my favorite things about Neos. Oh, I'm glad. I'm glad you feel that way. It'll be even better, I promise you, you guys. Like, this is just, again, Neos is all still very beta, but still we have all this cool content that our users are doing out now. So we're gonna go through this world. Actually, I kind of want to walk through this way. Yeah. It kind of feels like One Piece, doesn't it? Torquing saying One Piece, but it's not spelt like peace. It's peace, like you're taking a chunk off peace, not peace like, hey man, let's pace out. Let's pace out, man. Yeah, beta early, I see, yeah. Plus, I feel like even when Neos is quote-unquote, like, ready for, like, showing, it's still never gonna be done. Because a metaverse, that's like, having a metaverse be done is, like, kind of like saying, like, the internet is gonna be, like, done. It just is continual. It's a continual thing. So... the more people, the more it snowballs, right? Of things and contents of things that can be created.
It's logarithmic.
Oh, you download the entire internet? Nice. Sounds good. Sounds legit.
Oh, just like Russell did.
I wish we finished the internet. That would be great.
No, it'll never be.
Hey, one thing that's going to be nice is probably this year we're going to have a screen share mode. So imagine that, you know, just bring in your computer screen and have that out. Yeah, let's go up there. That looks nice. I got the hiccups now. Oh, no. Oh, no. Sorry. Hiccups. Hey, Aegis. What's up there, buddy? Yeah. Drink some water. Oh, thanks, you guys. I'm glad that you're concerned of me. Ooh, Okay, and yep, I gotta grab. I said, hey, how you doing, buddy? Wow, look at the view up here, you guys. What do you guys think? Pretty good, huh?
Rocks, more trees.
Yeah, thumbs up. Also, the name of this place, you guys, is Pirate Island, and this was made by Envirex, and all the worlds that we're showing off today are all the featured worlds. So yeah, if you want to check this out, unfortunately you cannot build inside of this world, but you can spawn out your own items, but you cannot use an editing tool inside of this world since all the items and assets from Envirex's worlds are locked down. So you cannot use their assets, but you can enjoy the way that they look in VR, which are quite pretty. Quite nice looking. And I always love the sound effects that he adds to the environments too.
There's another watchtower. I thought you were on it.
No, I'm on this one.
Yeah, I accidentally I was trying to teleport on that rock. Wait, can I?
Yeah. And yeah, you can join via desktop mode. Absolutely, Mr. L.
Yes, you can join in desktop, but I could not climb.
Okay, everyone, I'm going to now jump off of this thing. Dragon says, I am honestly very impressed with all this. A couple of friends of mine recommended this game to me, and now that I've seen what you can do, I plan on joining this weekend. Awesome job. Aww. That's so kind of you, Dragon. I'm glad that you feel that way. Neos for me is not just my job, but it is my passion. It is something that I care about very deeply, and I just want to be sure that people can connect and socialize in the best possible way and collaborate together and build together in VR. So I'm just glad that, you know, you guys are enjoying it so far, and hopefully it gets even better and better and better to where even your friends will start coming inside of here and enjoying it as well, because, hey, and then they'll be like giants and then just like waving to you. So Miles says, how much of this world is modeled using the tools inside of Neos VR and port itself? So the one world that I'm going to show that's going to be like the one that's going through, they used almost all the assets inside through Neos only. This one, on the other hand, though, I believe is an import through Unity. So I think they're using the Unity SDK that we have for Neos, and they're importing out the scene that they've built out in Unity and then imported it through. But there are plenty of worlds that have been made in Neos, just strictly and entirely in Neos. And all of the worlds that I've built in Neos have been strictly and entirely in Neos. Which I can actually show off a world during the stream that was entirely built out within here. Yep, he does quite a bit of importing. But they're quite nice worlds, and I really like the look of them. Aw, thank you, Dragon. Very kind of you. Riri says, just subscribe on Patreon because you allow exporting. Love to support companies that don't lock their users in. Absolutely. Here's one thing that we do completely different than other companies when it comes to Neos. We really want it to be that the users and the community that are inside of here benefit the most from it. And I really do believe in that because, again, for me, I feel like it's our community that has gotten us to this point anyways, so it's really important to me that we have anything and everything that the community wants to be able to be inside of here, too. Also, look, we have Frox. Hello, Frox.
Some around in the bushes.
Frox is one of the main coders and developers here at Neos.
He's the one that built it from the ground up.
Yep. Incredibly smart, this one. Very nice to see you. Frox rarely comes out of his hole from the coding hole. But that's okay. Nice to have you here with us, man. I think that the Unreal Engine demo is really awesome, but I don't think it's going to be something that's going to impact VR for quite a while until the hardware gets there for people's computers and such. At least for running like real-time VR. But maybe one day we can have some really high-end graphics, high-end everything running out through Neos. Um, Actually, this is a pretty interesting question that Alertius asks. Is there a way to follow, or is there a way to allow forking a world one publishes, like a GitHub repo? Is that... Yeah, it is.
Because you can have, like, a... You can do save as, kind of like how you're saving as, like, a model or image. You can just save as, like, another world if you have the permissions to. And there is a group system within Neos. It'll be further fleshed out once the new UI comes out. We can have, like, group worlds, group inventories, and, like, a group list of, like, users within it, of course.
Yep, so save as, and then you can save out the world in your own. Your own copies.
Mm-hmm. And that's if you have the permission to.
Yep. This isn't even the new UI snooper. This is just the new icons for the new UI. So Frox is still working on the new facets for that. What are you doing? Yeah. Really? Yeah, none of that is the actual new UI. It's just the icons. Yeah, they're
icons. The icons will be used in the new UI.
Really? My gosh. But yeah, let's show off the rest of this world, and then we'll be moving on to the next one. Alertitious says, so there is a granular permission to allow anyone to save as, but not any editing? Yes. So I can click on a save as for a world, but there is permissions that are locked on for a certain user. But you can still save out a world. If the permissions allow for it.
Yeah, there's different permission levels that people can use.
I'm not sure if it even is like saves that. Mm-hmm. But like if I tried to equip a, like in this world specifically, if I tried to equip a dev tooltip, I wouldn't be able to equip it. See? There you go. But it's still a very nice environment. It's a good place to, you know, come hang out, talk. It's very big and open, so you're not gonna have people getting anxiety. But I usually like to be very close to people. Okay, thanks. Yeah, thanks, dude. Frox is in the water.
I'll fall.
Just chilling on the beach.
Okay, so would you guys like to now go off to the next world?
Yeah, what's it called?
So, the next one that we're going to is Domain, and this one is by Canadian Git. What's your question, man?
Have you showed the stream his world yet?
Which one?
It's still in progress, the pool map.
Yeah. But it's still very nice. Show it off, maybe.
I'll show it off probably when the time when he actually releases it, because I know that he's waiting for it to be released.
I really want to get it done, and I've been working on a lot of other stuff too at the same time.
Okay.
Yep.
Including the new Neo streaming.
Okay. So we are in our new world, and this world, again, is by Canadian Git, and it is Domain. Let me switch over to fly real quick. Welcome, Frox. Yes, it is very neat. So, an interesting thing about this world is, I'll actually show you right now, as this light sphere passes through, the pillars will actually open up. So you'll see it here in a second. This cool gyroscopic looking object is going to pass through this and it's going to open up that. So you'll see it in a second. Slowly.
You do have, under your session menu, to answer your question, under your session menu in your dashboard, under the users tab, you have the ability to kick and ban users from that world specifically.
It's a really cool effect that goes on there. Another amazing effect about this world is I can actually jump off the edge and I will end up falling from the sky. So that sky that's up there, if I jump down right here, Frox is now jumping down there and he's gonna eventually come falling from the sky after a while. So let's wait for him and see if he falls down.
Yes.
Oh, there he is. And he fell from the sky.
Sure,
he went, but you jumped down there. How'd you come from up there? Here, I'll try it. Woo! There you go. So a really cool effect for a world. It's also quite optimized, and it's a nice place to, I feel like, even come inside and probably even do some like editing or building, or maybe even use this world for like creating an avatar or something like that, so you could have a nice platform and build out inside of here. Plus it has really cool effects and nice sounds inside of the environment, plus these pillars that are moving and doing all their cool stuff.
Hey,
thanks, Salon. Hey, Al. Nice to see ya.
Session menu.
So, yeah, you, absolutely sleeping, you can kick anyone that you want out of your session by just changing the permissions on those people. And I do have to apologize if anyone is harassing you inside of Neos or anything like that. Just be sure that you have the power to block them as a person or get them out of your world by banning them. But yeah, so really awesome. We already got some other awesome people here inside of us. Join us on stream. Oh, look, and they're sleeping. I see ya.
Just make a suggestion. Make sure you take a picture of them.
Yo, yo, yo. And yeah, that was a superhero landing there, Snooper. Super, super. But yeah, really awesome world. Again, this world domain from Canadian Git. And we'll go on now to the next one. And remember, you guys, were the reason why we're showing off all this content is because at the end of every month, we have a user creation contest or user showcase for the end of the stream. And with that, we're, you know, able to show off all the cool stuff that was made out for this month of May inside of Neos. And we're going to be going off now to the next one. This is another world by Enverex, and this one is the Floating Town. Thank you for answering questions in the chat there, Aegis. Next world, we are going to the Floating Town. I'll also close down some other worlds so that it doesn't get like all piled up. My favorite thing about this place has to be the skybox, I'd say. Really, really beautiful view. And great lighting.
Hey, Nexalon.
Hey, what's up, friend?
Do you know anybody who can quickly help me with my avatar real quick?
You just have to ask around.
Okay.
I don't have people on demand.
I don't want to bother you during stream.
If I had people on demand, then I would already, you know, be in a very good state. I wish that was the case.
Yeah, I don't want to bother you during stream.
Yes, I'm streaming right now, my dude. Otherwise, I would help you. A monsoon base says, next lies, he has so many slaves. Well, I mean, not so many. But yeah, so we're inside of this new world that we're here, the Floating Town by Enverix. Really cool place. We got, yeah, Snooper's like, wow, okay. But yeah, this is a really nice place if you want to, you know, bring your date, you know, but that's about it. Seriously, if you bring your date to a place that looks like this, I think you'll probably fall in love, right? I mean, that nice, like, sunset, the good food, the alcohol, I mean, it's everything you need. And including this cute thing. Like, come on. That's adorable. There have already been dates in VR, a Moon Sun of Bays. I promise you, this has already happened. Imagine having a date at all. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, look at this. Like, look at this lighting. Like, doesn't it look great, Frox? That looks pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, it looks really nice.
Quite pretty indeed. And another trip, you guys, is just, you know, walking through these areas and, again, just being in virtual reality and seeing around you and seeing these cool places that people have done out in here. The only thing that I'd say that it's missing is we got to be able to, like, have a fishing pole now and just, like, reel out the fishing pole and then go, like, pull out a fish. Heck yeah. Are there streams in building these levels? So we don't have streams that are that complex, I would say, but maybe down the line we could possibly do something where we do like a advanced in-depth how to build out a world, because you could build a world out like this in Neos itself, but I'm pretty sure this sort of world would be imported out through Unity. But yeah, if you want to build out levels or build out worlds, yeah, I mean, that could definitely be a possible thing. This stream currently, no, this is just showing off the cool content that users have done out and have uploaded for the worlds, as well as some additional items that have been made out. Like, let me spawn out something that was made out. Which I'm sure you guys have already seen this thing. There might be some new users here that are not acquainted with our friend. Isn't he beautiful? A monsoon base is like, oh god, not again, not this. So we're saying the trigger is making your eyebrows give a silly look when you pull it. Yeah, I know. That's because I have my grip trigger is doing a voice. Yeah, I got different facial emotes. So, like, I can make my pupils go big. Here, wait, I'll actually zoom the camera on my face so you guys can see. Make my pupils go big. Stick my tongue out. So, yeah. Yes, emotions. Thank you. I'm glad you like them, Dark. And that's the end of this area. Quite nice. Really like it. Again, this world is the Floating Town by Enverix, and really cool. We have this as a featured world and definitely a nice place to probably invite your friends and just hang out and talk. Can you ride the boat? I could go on top of the boat if I really want to, I think. Let's see. Oh, yeah, I guess you can. Yeah, they're already up there. Oh, and there goes Frox. He died. He drowned because he didn't know how to swim. I'm going to just teleport there, though. Come on. There we go. Oop. I'm going to go on that one. There we go. I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Mm-mm. There we go. Can you ride the boat? Yeah, I think I need a license. I'm pretty sure. Yep, I don't have a boating license. Sorry. Sorry, you guys. You have to chauffeur me around. Chauffeur? Where are you, chauffeur?
Well, we just need a shark and we can just call it Jaws.
Awesome. Smart Frox.
Frox is just like,
okay. Ingenious. He's like, I'm just going to use my jetpacks. That's Frox right there. And there he goes, off into the sunset. The most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
I knew I should have caught that Pokemon a long time ago.
Beautiful. Just fades away into the mountain. Okay. Anyways, you guys, on to the next world. We'll do it on the boat. My gosh. So the next one that we're going to be going to is The Japanese Village and Shrine by Amberix as well. And we'll start a new session. Wow. So this is a really another pretty environment. And definitely want to show it off. Also has really good nature sounds. It's very calming. Yeah, I would say that Neos is performing better and better each and every single day. Frox is working very hard at making Neos run better and better. So we got this really pretty environment, you guys. And I'm actually just going to, we're going to walk through this obviously, but I want to show just the scale and the amount that's through here just by scaling up a little bit so you guys can kind of like get an idea of like how big this is. So it's a really big area. And I'll shrink myself back down. I'll even turn up the multimedia just a little bit. My frames are crying just looking at it. I'm so sorry, Minsa. Hey, but it's running well on stream though, right, you guys? Are you getting good frames for the camera? At least you can see it through this way. Oh, thanks for being in chat. Smooth frames. Buttery smooth. Butter. Trisky says, I tried the game for the first time when I played with you. Really nice community and really fun. We'll be playing more. Aw, sounds good, man. Definitely would love to have you back inside of here. And I have to agree, we have such a very kind and awesome community so far, and the people that we have that care about VR so much, I'm so thankful to have such awesome people. Also, TriSky, definitely join our Discord, discord.gg/NeosVR, or the link is at the side. If you ever need help, our community is always willing to help people inside of here, such as setting up characters or setting up worlds or just in general, just help with Neos. So be sure to join the Discord, you guys. It's really, really important. And if this is your first time ever seeing Neos, for you guys watching on the Twitch channel, be sure to download it. It is completely free, and you can use it on desktop, too. It's just not recommended because it is a VR software. Nice. Hey there, Frox. I love how you're just like squat walking, just like through the whole thing. Okay. Hello?
Hello.
Hello. Are you doing okay in that pot?
Yes.
Good, because you look awesome in it. Here, I'll chill in the other pot. There you go. We're pot buddies. Here, Pyro, take a picture. Take a picture of us. Hey, thanks. Heck yeah. The Frox has been contained. Yes, he's been contained. What? He needs to be. He's way too jumpy sometimes. Plant Sim VR. Yeah, I know, right? We're like little planters. Oh, I'm sprouting. I'm sprouting, you guys.
Next floor.
You can't be doing pot on stream. No way. Oh, thank you. Wow, look, Frox, look at this picture. You're like a beautiful golden daisy, and I'm like a weed plant. No, I'm just kidding. I'm joking. Yeah. Just those pesky ones that you get in the lawn, though, right? I'm an aloe plant? Oh, okay. I guess that's what I am. I'm an aloe plant. Yeah, I guess I could say that. I'm healing. I'll heal the skin. Let's show off more of the world. Aloe vera, yeah. I head pot. The FBI would like to request your location. You head pot? I don't know why you head pot. I thought you just smoke it. I don't know why you head it. I know what you meant. I'm just playing with you, Dragon. Yes. Gosh, this... And I love this, like, water that's going, like, underneath here. The only thing that's missing is just, like, an actual waterfall just going shh. That'd be great. FBI is smoking what they take. Probably. They probably are. No.
I'm stuck.
That's, I'm not going to say that. How are we... Why are we squatting right now? I don't understand why we're squatting right now. Why am I... I don't have, like, my... I don't get it. It doesn't make a sense to me. Do I have to stand up? No, not even that works. What a weird situation we are in.
This is a video from Zyro.
Oh, okay. So, do I play this?
I mean, if you want to.
Me.
Okay then.
This is an image from Electrospy. He says, "Speaking of next being a plant."
Speaking
right here in front of you.
Wow, that actually looks like a plant. Not gonna lie.
Yeah.
Well, cool. I'm glad that got captured and saved forever. So yeah, Plantulin, oh gosh, oh no. You guys are always so special.
They have to start and some first is gonna make calls with Max now.
Yep, time to use the hammer on you guys. You've been naughty. Oh, Aja stole my hammer. Never mind. My gosh. What a Friday. Okay. So, we're heading off to the next world. Again, this world is a Japanese village and shrine and is featured world by Envirex. The next world that we're going to be going to is by... Next rule we're going to be going to is by Blackadder, and is the Infinite Sea Public. So we're going to be going on an even bigger boat this time, you guys. Wow. Thank you. Yep, stealing's off by default. Holy ship! I know it is holy ship, isn't it?
I have the chair right here in my hand.
Is it the streamer one?
Yep, we world hop fast here inside of Neos because our loading times are significantly lowered and you load almost immediately. So welcome to this beautiful ship world. We also got all our peeps back inside of here again. Here, let's climb up this. Oh, this is one beautiful ship, to say the least. Here, wait, let me climb up here. Okay. We're on a boat, you guys. Isn't that great? And we have this awesome music playing through. It's very detailed. With the ocean and all. Look at that water. Look at that water, you guys. Look at that skybox with the bar. Guys, look at that. Beautiful water. Look at. So proud. I know, right? I just wanted to take some time. Just like 5 seconds of our day to just appreciate that water. Okay? We're appreciating it. And don't forget to drink it, too. Remember to stay hydrated, Pyro. Stay hydrated.
Will do.
Good. Yes, we're on a boat. Here, I'll actually zoom the camera out all the way so you guys can get a good view of us being on the camera. We'll keep going. We're still zooming out. I'll even go up a little bit for the camera. Thank you. I'm kind of a professional with this camera. So we're just gonna zoom out so you guys can see how big this boat is. It's a pretty damn big boat. Look at that, you guys. That pretty, pretty boat. There we go. Oh, that's the Twitch chat right there. Oh gosh. M-Blade is saying, wish we had these controls in VRC. Yeah, the camera controls inside of Neos are really, really awesome, and we actually even want to improve upon them even more as time goes on. Oh, this is just like me, like, rotating. It's just following the whole thing. I'll just hit reset.
You can climb.
And there goes Rox. Another nice thing inside this world, there's also a bottom area that you can go down, that which was the area that we spawned in. And it's a little bit dark, but you can have, like, I'm guessing, like, a mirror right down here with a light. and some other areas. I believe there's like a captain's area, I believe that's up here, and we'll show off the captain's area. Taroid says, are worlds indexed centrally, or can you host and join a server on an arbitrary IP? Sorry for basic question, this looks great. I have to try it. I would say, yeah, you actually can host it. You can host worlds on a headless server, and then they can be continually open as worlds, and then anyone can join that headless world, and then that would stay open. So, like, let's say if everyone was to... If this world was on a headless world and everyone was to crash, the world would still stay open for another person to join. Mblade also says, does Neos have any dance/rave clubs with YouTube/stream players? Yes, there is. Why isn't this bigger than VR chat? I don't know. I guess, I don't know. So, I think this is the captain's quarters right here. It's probably because we don't do any advertisement for Neos. I'd say that's probably the biggest thing. We don't advertise it out as much. At least not yet. So let's go in through right here, get into the captain's quarters. Looking quite nice. Oh yeah, definitely. If you want Mblade, I can actually show you a dance world that I've been working on. It's still a heavy work in progress type world, but we can actually show that on this stream. I don't mind showing it. Would you like to see that? Okay. We can show that right after this one. They're saying, I hosted the dances for Ferali last weekend, wondering how viable this would be for a large event. Oh, absolutely. Like, yeah, this could be hosted up for large events pretty easily, I would think. As long as they're separated in sections and worlds, and as long as they're using optimized avatars and characters. Okay, so, I mean, yeah, let's go check out that place. But again, let's get a nice last look at that beautiful water and vista. Brings a tear to my eye. There we go. Here, we'll even get him. Get a nice water view. A nice water view for chat. This is for you, chat. Just breathe in all of that salt water. Ah. You just smell the ocean? Yeah, it smells like clams. Yeah. Taroid says, oh, so the worlds are stored on people's PCs and go live when someone runs one. I think I saw a Neos VR hub mentioned somewhere, though. Is that like a local hub? No, it wouldn't be like that. Everyone opens up their own session. And unless you create your headless world, the session that you open up is going to be the one that you're hosting. So think of it as like you're hosting like a Discord call. That's like how sessions in VR sessions work. I'm hosting it right now because I'm the host. So think of it as like you're hosting a call. So you host the world, host the call, or but if it's headless, nobody has to host. The only person that hosts it is your PC. And that would be the host, and it's just continually on. If that makes sense, hopefully. But yes. Okay, we're going to go off into the next world now. So, considering that Mblade is wanting to see a dance type world, I am going to show that to them right now, even though that it's still a heavy work in progress, and it's not finished yet, but this is my world, so I'll show it off right now. The reason why I say it's not finished is because the dance stage is not completed yet, but this is a dance zone Neo Tokyo, and I'm going to start a new session. Okay. So for inside of this world, I put a photosensitive seizure warning. And this is also a very good idea to place this inside of your worlds, you guys. Because if you don't, you want to be sure that also, Gory, I think you're grabbing onto me, Gory. Thanks. Yep, this is from the Creator GM, and if you just want to exit out of it, you can just click on that thumbs up to know that this is a environment that's probably going to have flashing lights and such. So you got this big area of a giant Neo Tokyo with a giant screen that you can play whatever YouTube video you'd like with whatever music, and all the music is reactive to the area and to the buildings. Again, this is still a work in progress. They still need to add more buildings and more stuff to the stage environment and other cool things. Hey, I see ya. Yep. So, and then if you want, you can play whatever... Oh, sorry. Let me go third person, then switch that back. So I can type in with using UIX. I can type in whatever video that I would like in the channel, and I can even have a playlist right here, and this is a YouTube playlist, so I can bring in YouTube videos inside of here and have them projected out right here, and I can type this in real time and have my keyboard and just paste it in directly. Yep, and it shows the actual list, so I can change to whatever music that I would like to be played on here, which you know, is really good, and that music is going to be reactive over here as well. Eventually, this dance stage is going to have reactive floors. It's going to have a whole bunch of different things that you'll be able to do for dancing. But currently, for right now, we have like this dotted screen display that looks quite cool. So you can see it leaves off kind of like this trail kind of effect, at least for right now. But I really want to go over this world until it gets... I'm going to publish this one once the whole dance stage is completed and the environment is completed. Yep, it's doing God rays. Yep. Another thing... yep. Another thing about this place is you can go through the doorways inside of here. So if you want to get to the... You mentioned the visuals react to audio. Yes, the visuals do react to audio. So if there's no audio playing through, it's not going to show up. So you can see, like, now it's like the audio's up, and now it's going to show and be reactive to the music. Also, this is reactive to the music as well. And the speaker box right here is reactive to the music as well. Oh, here, let me turn up the volume of the speaker. Let me bring it down here. It's pretty cool. Bring it with us. So we can open up this door, and then we walk through the door, and it teleports us out to the other side of the building. And obviously all the Neo City is partying with us. We'll go out to this through this door too. This is how you get on the top building. Ooh. Try to get there without falling. There you go. Oh, nice, Emblade. Thank you for that. There's the dance stage right there. And so here's my idea, you guys. For this world, I'm actually going to have a giant blimp that will fly around, and it'll have the camera on the person who's dancing. So then the whole person will think of all of these top buildings people will be able to hang out on, and they'll be able to watch the main dancer in the main area. So that person will be able to dance right there, and everyone will be able to watch all from there on the giant screen that will be flying on a blimp. It'll be pretty cool. Yep. But still not done quite yet, but it will be. I am now gonna jump off the building and fly. Okay, here we go. Oh, I try. So that's just one of mine. It's still a work in progress, and this one is a world that I did out as well as the help with some of the community, and it's called Dance Zone Neo Tokyo. But eventually, it's going to be released out during June. How many do you expect to exist in a world? 30 typical? I mean, I wouldn't say 30 is typical, but I would say maybe in a world like this, maybe like 15 to 20. 15 and 20 would be pretty fine. But yeah. So, we'll go on now to the next world, because I would like to showcase off the rest of the worlds that the community has. Oh, no problem, M-Blade. We're actually gonna go to another type of like music world, and you guys can probably even like choose out different stuff. So this one is from a small cookie, and it's called Musical Invasion. And this world is similar to, let me just turn down the volume a little bit. It's similar to my world with a reactive kind of music stuff. Oh, thank you, Black Jungle. I'm glad you like the place. And yeah, load times are very quick inside of Neos. And no problem. I'm glad you liked it, dude. So you can see that the music is reactive to the stuff inside of it. And remember, all the logics and all the connections were made out in Neos. So all this sound design, all the stuff was done out in here using our logics. So. And you can play whatever music you'd like as well. And Small Cookie, the person who made out this world, was the same person who made out the UIX for the video player. And you can actually open up this video. If you guys have any recommendations of some like music that you'd like to hear inside of here, as long as it's copyright free or it's open to use, we could like play a music video or play whatever you guys would like in chat if you want to. And we can have it. Frox is gonna play it and wants to play Doom music. Yeah, probably. It's usually when it's on pause, it flickers between the two. On and On by Cartoon. Yeah, we can try that jailfoot. Let me search it up on YouTube. She's like, huzzah! Yeah, I just gotta find it on YouTube real quick. Okay, so, oh, I'm glad. Oh, thank you. I think you're talking about my character. If so, thank you. Okay, so I'm searching up. This is a song recommended by Shiel.
Side. I don't wanna waste what's left. Jason leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays.
My character is in a volley. I can actually set my camera so it does world. Cameras do some awesome stuff. Very good choice, Shalefoot. Good choice on music. We're gonna go now to the next world. So again, this was by Small Cookie called Musical Invasion. We're also gonna now go to Bars, a very similar world, and this one was done by Aegis. Not Aegis Wolf, but Aegis the Avali. I know, confusing. Confusing. Very confusing, but you know. We are starting our new session now. And into the new world, and obviously you can tell we immediately popped into this world. That took like what, like that took like what, 1 or 2 seconds to get into this world. The multimedia is like blasting. Somebody was like, when they made this world, they were like pump jamming. They were like pump jamming. Also, did my audio go out? Oh no, it's just. There we go. So now this is kind of like that scene from like Ready Player One where they like throw that disco ball, right? No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, sorry that it was loud. I turned it down. So we got another music reactive environment. You can kind of dance inside of here. Also got the same UI for the video right up here. Now it's just big and behind you. So you can have your music video, whatever you like. More environments. These ones are already public worlds, by the way. The one that I showed off, the Neo Tokyo one, is not a public world. These two are public worlds that you can join right now. But yeah. Black Jungle says, Mike, give us an about on your UI. So what do you mean by quotations about? Get straight to the point, my dude. What do you want me to say about it? And I'll be able to answer any questions. If you have questions about the UI, I do not mind answering. Yes. Neo Tokyo, yeah. What's happening there? That does not look like VRC. Yeah, it's not VRC. This is Neo's VR. It's amazing. It's VR creation all within world. You don't have to use Unity at all. You can all build inside of Neo's. Neo's is here. Neo's is now. Neo's is 2020. Neo's is the future of VR. You should be in it if you love VR. I'm serious. You really should. And, yeah. It's, yes. It's Neo's. Neo's. But, and again, this world, what we like to do for the end of the month, for every single month at the end for our Friday streams, we like to show off all the cool content made out by our community. This one is called Bars and is made by Aegis. The future is now!
Yes. We will build the great Neo's.
We are not making a Neo's wall. we're not doing that. Yes, I regret that even being on stream. My gosh.
Come on, man.
Treasure.
It's our treasure.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll be moving now to the next one. You guys kind of get the idea of this one. It's very, you know, synth wave kind of like environment. Okay, next world that we'll be going off to, you guys. Ah, the main attraction. This one is by Innocent Thief, and this one is The Maze Chapter 1. I think you guys are really gonna like this one. Let me be sure to click join and not. Oh yeah. My neck. I'm so excited, you guys. You guys are so freaking cool. I love all of you. You know what I mean? One at a time, you guys. Jeez, you're gonna crash me joining all at once. I think you already did. Not gonna lie. Oh. Okay. There we go. We're loading in, you guys. The Maze. Welcome to The Maze. Real corn hour. Okay. This isn't that kind of maze, you guys. This is gonna be so much cooler. So much cooler. I promise. Okay, let's put this on in a third person. We'll wait for everyone to like load in here, and I hopefully will not have like the dying of my frames. Let me close out of this real quick.
And we're here. Kind of.
Yep, I'm just waiting for my system to load. Yeah, it's amazing. Amazing. Good keywords there. Yeah. Amazing. So amazing. Give me one sec, you guys. I'll just put the camera not on me as I, like, disintegrate into the ground. So, we're going to be going through this, I'm going to put the one of the clues right here and look down at it. People are just joining, so I'll leave the clue right there on manual while I adjust something. Hopefully you guys can read what that says on chat. But boy, why are you moving it? I just put it on the camera. I swear. Am I being ignored? I feel like
it's
it.
Like, let me just put this camera right on it.
Let me just, you know, completely mess up everything that you were trying to do. Like, come on, man. Like, I'm trying to be nice to the stream here. So you guys can read what that says. I'll just give me like 1 minute. I'll be right back. I have to get something.
Just give the clues to Ferg so he can. I think Nex needs to get Braga.
And before it's just
wow, thank you, Snooper, for that 5,000 bits. Very kind of you. Party time. Party time, you guys!
Ooh.
Okay, so we'll read this out.
Damn, son, where you find it?
Let me zoom this in. So it says, we finally found the entrance. The last clue brought us here to the hidden place. On our journey, we lost most of our materials. Luckily, we were able to save a torch needed when entering the cave. We started exploring the cave, lighting the first bowl on the right side. Hey, boy, don't you...
I just found it. I wasn't gonna run off.
The stream has to see it, too. Frickin' Beaned. Just running off there, going on a frickin' adventure without us. Boy, we are here. Instantly mad. Don't mess with me right now. Anyways, where was I? I'm trying to get into the lore of this. Shit. Okay. We start exploring the cave. Laying the first bowl on the right side started a chain of lights that with a lit tower far away looks like a maze with a riddle to be solved to enter. Wish us luck to survive whatever awaits us behind these walls. Well, okay. So, that's the start of it, obviously.
I found the torch. I know. I didn't know if you realized I found the torch.
I'm glad, dude. Group effort. No, we're going to need you guys, because honestly, it is a group effort. This is a group puzzle experience, so we're going to be going through here. Obviously, there's this little hole walkway that we go through right here. And it gets a little bit dark when we're inside this environment.
So okay. So,
yep. So watch out, Frox. I'm going to light it up, okay? Let me... wait, give me 1 second.
I know.
You're like, do it.
Fucking Bean, shut up.
Okay, I'm just waiting because let me actually I might have to close off this. I might have to close off the session, or actually I'm gonna close down all these other worlds. Give me 1 second, you guys. I have like so many worlds open right now, and they just need to be closed. That's why I'm like dying. And please do not light the flame. Yeah. I just want to make sure that's clear for the stream.
I'm not doing anything. Gee.
Oh, I know you're not. I just have to close down my worlds.
Like, before someone holds it and they get, like, zooped and it, like, zoops into it.
Just, yeah.
I mean, not trying to, like, say that that might happen anything.
My laser's pointing at Bean.
I'm literally closing that down, like, 10 worlds right now, you guys, so sorry about this.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
You got a data set, then? Or...
Well, I didn't close them down as I was, like, leaving the other ones. Okay. So now we're here, completely dying. Okay, so cool. So we're gonna light this up? Okay. So here we are. We're at the front part of the puzzle to go through, and we have our torches. So what can you guys think so far? Have you?
I wish there was a paper around here somewhere.
Have you played through this before, Bean?
No, I have. Well,
yes, I have.
Yes and no, but I don't know the paper positions. Well. And I literally just saw it.
Okay, so we have a paper here. We have a clue, obviously.
The things I know, I will not.
The clue says, we tried to open the main entrance for the last 2 days. What we found out so far, there are symbols visible in the light of the torch. We found corresponding symbols on the side of the walls and in the bowls. The wall symbols have different colors. There must be a special order on how the light... The fire on how to light the fire, we suppose it's related to the colors and the position of the symbols on the wall. Okay, so what do you think that means?
I'm not gonna lie, that kind of went like
so you asked.
Okay, well, these are the people that I have solving this puzzle with me, so Good on me for that one. So let me try maybe like lighting one of these. Oh, well, there we go. Okay, so these like light up. We got this, Chad. I also see there's the symbols on them when I bring the light over it. So you can see it goes dark and I bring the symbol over it.
No.
Oh, I guess I was wrong. It's saying no.
It says something about symbols on the wall.
Give me a duplication of that torch real quick.
You want a duplicate? Okay, here. You can have a duplicate. So we gotta figure this out.
Okay, so let's see.
It said something about symbols on a wall, right?
Yeah, symbols on the wall. So try to look for symbols on the wall.
This wall?
There's one right here.
Oh, with the torch. Okay.
Okay, cool. So we got one symbol.
How are my acting skills?
So those are three shurikens. One of these shurikens.
Here's another one. Here's another symbol right here, you guys. There's another symbol. Yep. Let me scan the area. Oh, look. Oh, this one's green. Look at this one, you guys.
Go green.
That's a green one.
I highlighted one by accident. Here, let me just start this over real quick.
Oh. Another green one right here.
There. I just reset it because I hit one of the flinches. So, let's see.
So, did you find any ones over here? Oh, here's another green one. I think we have to use the green ones.
Yeah. I want the green ones.
Yeah, this one's white. Oh, here's another green one. Okay, so, and I think it's for the corresponding number.
And three swirls.
Do you got it?
Three swirls.
Are you looking for number four?
Mm-hmm.
Your number four is over here.
Yeah, here are those two shurikens.
Right?
Mm.
That's number four. So four swirls.
Really?
Nope. I guess that's a no.
Here, wait, let me try it.
This one.
Fair enough.
He's already mastered so he can do it on stream. He's like, yeah.
Hey, this part I actually don't know what to do, to be honest with you.
It's just a maze, I guess, at this point.
Wait, no, it's a little bit more than just that. I have been in through here, but I haven't like actually like solved it. Oh yeah, this is we can't go this way.
I think I kind of remembered the path, so I'm just gonna follow you.
Also, I don't think that we need the torches anymore, so we're just gonna leave this right here.
Oh yeah, right.
Yep. Okay, so, which way do we want to go? Do we want to go right or left? Wait, where did Frox go? Where'd the rest of the guys go? What the heck? We're being left behind! What happened to No Child Left Behind? I was around in that area. What happened to that? Oh, shit. I'm on Simba's like, LOL. LOL! Let's go. Okay.
Someone died?
So wait, yeah, let's keep going this way. Yeah, sure. You keep on going. I mean, you want me to walk over lava here now? What is this? What is this, man? You go. You go first.
I will be.
There we go. What in the fuck is that? Ew! What the fuck?
Why are you walking on the walls? That's illegal.
Hey, you know this would be so much. Wait. I gotta turn off name tags. No. Wait, we're turning off name tags right now. Here, let me see.
This is why I pulled it out. The model that I've been working on, I'm still not done with it.
Oh, no.
Okay. Yeah. Wait.
Tag.
We're turning off name tags just so then that's like 10 times more creepy. Hell yeah. Oh, and he just disappeared. Oh, and he got shot. Wait, did you kill him?
No.
What happened to him? Where did he disappear?
Here, boy.
What? Oh.
It's his avatar.
Oh my gosh. Wait,
my avatar, it turns invisible completely.
Oh, it turns invisible. Oh, that's not a nightmare at all. Imagine. Yeah. Wait, do your tongue thing again. Imagine that's a sound effect. Ooh. Ew. Freaking gross.
I'm working on the sound effects.
Exactly that.
I do my own voice recordings, I know.
See, actually, we need to have the same place, but we need to have it during Halloween. This place needs to be, like, redesigned for Halloween, and have it to be, like, a scare area. Oh, what a joy it would be. What a joy. Isn't that a great idea, you guys? Come on, let's come over here, you guys.
Follow the
dee
da dee da
da dee da da dee da da dee da da.
Wait, that's
we got something here, you guys. What are you thinking?
It's a bagel.
It's a bagel, yeah.
It's a sacrifice a table.
Okay, so we got a clue here. Yeah. It says, after exploring the maze for a while, we found this room. There are two locked doors and a table. We solved the memory and opened both doors. We haven't heard of the half of our team that have took the other way. Well, yeah, where the heck is Frox? And the rest of them?
He's out way over there.
Okay, well, they took the other way.
There's only one. I can find them if I want to, but I'm not going to.
So,
oh, wait, so what?
This is a table?
Okay, yeah, this is a table.
And you need to lay on it, and we need to sacrifice you.
Will you get out of here? I've already done that during the last stream. You should have checked up on our last stream, because I've already been sacrificed.
I've been there.
Hey, that's some Neo's trivia right there. I have been sacrificed in one of our Neo streams before. This is the kind of content that you get here, guys. Anyways, this is a memory matching game, and it's to open up the door. So, yeah. We're going to match up stuff together until we open up a door.
What the hell? You're cheating.
Is Gory doing a good job? Is he, like, matching them up good? Oh. It's literally like a memory game, and if you don't flip the right one, they just flip back over. So, it's that kind of a puzzle game. Let's go.
You're going to do it one at a time, goddammit.
Yeah, you can only do it one at a time. I think... Which one... You have to match them for the corresponding color too. Do you want to help us with matching stuff, Rox? To open up the door? Do you want to try to help us to match up these things?
Is it like a match game?
Yeah, it's to match it up to open up the door. So once we get them a certain amount like finished out, then the door will open up.
Stop.
Jesus. We gotta coordinate.
Also, Mute Maxwell, thank you so much for that follow.
Sorry,
I can't jump in this map. I'm already triggered. I don't want to jump on Tim and be like, "Listen here, boy."
Oh, it's not triggering. Oh, you have to find three.
Yeah. Oh, see, there's that one and that one. Get those. Oh, wait. It did. Okay. It just did all. Okay. I don't know. whatever. Just continue on. Continue.
Oh, you can touch the platform with your hands.
God dang it.
What are we thinking? What are we thinking, guys? What are we thinking? This is a hard one.
I
this look find like the exact same color and shape, or?
Yeah, the same color and the same shape.
Yep.
Only the front three of them.
No, just two of them. Two of the same ones. Yeah, it's two
there
of the same ones.
Strings that didn't work.
Why would I try when there's people trying for me, and it's only one at a time that can go? Why would I try? Sammy Sensei's like, I think you're breaking the game. We probably are.
One at a time.
Yeah, if there's more than two people are shooting the table, they'll make a mess. Yeah, I know.
It's just not how you play the game.
It's gotta be organized, you guys. Organized. So one at a time.
That's why I'm sitting up here.
We just gotta memorize the pieces. Memorize the pieces, you guys. Memorize the pieces.
Remember the pieces. Races, pieces.
Yeah, that's the only Reese's Pieces I remember. Where's the Reese's Pieces at?
And always follow the heart.
Hey, I already did this once at like 10 a.m. I ain't doing this shit again. But I've only completed a certain... I think this is... Never mind. I'm not going to say anything. we're just gonna play through it. Yeah, no spoilers. I won't spoil.
Too small for that one.
Yeah, try to do it like once you find the match, just let each other know that you've matched it, other, so then we can.
Oh jeez,
we got a match.
We got a match. Got a match there.
I'm just gonna sit here and relax and watch everyone down there just like completely break the game.
This is the kind of content that you get inside of Neos. Wait, boy, nobody wants to see the back of your head, though. Shoot.
What?
The camera's
what
right
do you
there.
Mean?
I think we broke.
Oh, I'm sorry.
See the board. No, you're fine.
I'm sorry. I didn't. It's so dark in here.
Yeah, no, you're fine. It kind of blends in.
Yeah, I got two.
Here. You want it less dark? Here, I'll fix it.
You are, like, the creepiest thing right now. Will you...
Oh, no. You be quiet.
I swear.
I'm creepy, I'm just creepy.
So he clicked three of them, and all three of them disappeared. So it just broke the game.
That's gross.
We broke the game next.
We broke the game?
Yep.
There's another one.
What do you mean there's another one?
There's another one
on different.
There's another game.
Oh, there's an. Okay, then let's go to that one. Here, let's go.
Follow me.
Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Frox is leading the way now.
Dog! Played this map several times.
The Flukes.
Well.
Gotta show everything, Fluxy. Gotta show it all. Boy.
Okay, let's go. We're waiting on the other game.
Frog sounds so sleepy. He sounds so sleepy right now. It's so late for him. And we're in a dark environment.
It's 1 a.m. Yes. almost.
Yeah, for him it is. Wait, what time is it for you right now, Frox?
0:43.
0:43,
okay. There we go. And there's the game.
Oh my gosh, Angel. You're begging me to in case of bug, smash glass. In case of bugged glass, smash like. In case of bug, glass, and like, let me smash the glass. Okay. Fair enough, Angel. Okay, so this is another thing. What the heck? Nani?
What?
Nani? Did you see that? That thing moved. Look at that, you guys.
God, I'm scared. Let me eat the board now.
Nani? Oh wait, it's happening over here.
Brooks, what you need a table?
Until I go into a corner and activate the buttons.
Frox, you're just giving it all away, boy.
Hi, Brooks.
East Frog's like, I know. I'm just giving it all away. Oh, boy, that's... You're taking all the fun away from it. Taking all the fun when you do that.
I'm gonna hide myself now.
It was written on the document.
Yeah, it is written on the document. Yeah, you're right.
It's written on this.
I know, but the chat doesn't know that.
To read the document.
Give me that. Okay, Jazz, so here we go. After exploring the maze for a while, we found this room. There are two locked doors and a table with two buttons on each corner. What we found out so far, buttons are only active when someone else stands in the opposite corner. Pressing one of the buttons rotates half the stones in the opposite quarter. At a certain position, lava flows through the channels in the stones. Our guess is the lava has to reach the masks. We haven't heard of the half of our team that took the other way. Okay.
The masks of this one?
Okay, then. Well, I'm guessing we're gonna have to put that lava through the masks? The masks. Oh, the masks. Right here. The masks. There we go. There's the mask. The mask is right there. So, how are we getting that lava to the mask? Also, doing the most. Thank you so much for the follow. Thank you, doing the most. Oh. Amusa Beastsing will be here for years. Yeah, probably. We're getting this right. We're opening this door, okay? We're doing it so we can freaking showcase it, man. We gotta showcase this. We work together, you guys, so then this thing can be lava can pass through it. We gotta work our way together. Lava gotta pass through.
Dictatorship at its best.
Yeah. Dictatorship at its best. Yeah. Basically. Bah, this seems easy. Look, what do you mean? Look at what? We're moving things. We're trying to get the lava flowing. Considering that it's so hard to actually like see these light tiles for each one that's going through sometimes, well, it's not that hard, but Moon's up is like everyone's just randomly pressing things. Yeah, wait, can we wait for a second? We need to actually see with the lava flow. Everyone's just fucking pressing a button, like. Like, a moon son of babies is right here, you guys. We need to think. We need to use dunk, dunk, dunk the noggin. Okay? Use the brain. Oh, look. See, look. We're already getting lava coming through from that side. Now we just gotta... We're doing something right here. Can I... What has my life come to? There needs to be a sound effect for when I'm like knocking on somebody's head and just does like the hollow dong 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 sound. Dong dong dong.
Here next. You need a drink of this. It's a flask.
Oh, thank you. I think oh.
No, over here. I'm up here on the wall.
What in the hell? Are you kidding me right now? Are you kidding me? You guys are idiots. Give me that. What, a drink of this?
Yeah.
It's apple juice.
Can I open it?
Pretend. No, it's not done yet.
Thank you.
It's apple juice.
Oh, perfect.
Maybe if you go to the corner of me.
so I can press the button.
I am Gordon, man.
Yeah, I don't... Oh, wait. Oh. Well, there's Frox.
Okay, you have to do it again.
I think Frox died, you guys.
No, he just turned into a rock.
Oh, he turned into a rock. Of course, he got polymorphed. He got petrified. Moonstone Baby's like, Jesus, even Frox gave up. I know, that has to be some freaking determination of a puzzle when, you know, somebody like that is gonna give up on something. My gosh. Wait a second! I was all out of love! Shit. Can you...
Okay.
Wait. Okay, yeah. Oh, thank you for
the like to spear.
That's not me.
My gosh.
We got perks into the
what
rock.
In the heck? Oh, guess who back? Back again. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Hey, Outsider. Nice to see you. Welcome. Nice to have you around. Outsider 89. Welcome. Welcome. And welcome back to you.
It's gross.
It's going somewhere.
No, for the other button.
Ew. That's gross. So we'll just leave that there for reference.
Corner that you are right there. Okay, good.
Are you guys getting the lava through? No? I don't know. I think we're stuck inside. I think we're stuck inside of here, you guys. We stuck. We stuck life.
I'm just gonna hide for a while.
I'm just standing here, but...
Damn.
I don't...
Frox, you stand right here.
I'm helping.
Blaze, thank you for the Twitch Prime subscription. Thank you, my dude. Frox, you stand right there. Stand by the blue button. And I'll stand by this blue button. Or, no, stand by the red button. Stand by the red button, Frox. Yeah, stand by the red button, and then eight, but we're gonna do it one at a time, and we're gonna try to like look at the thing. Okay. So, wait, don't press any buttons yet. Don't press any buttons.
None of the buttons.
Movie Stone sound stream. Yeah, I know, right? Okay, let's see here. So I think we gotta move. I don't know which one that we gotta move. I don't know which one I gotta move. Well, this one definitely has to get. Yeah, maybe try that one. Let's see where that goes. That just brought that back over to there. Oh, we already did move all of them, fish. I think we did. Here, I'll stand by mine.
Press the blue one once it lights up.
Yes. Okay. Move all of them back. Okay.
Blue one.
I press the blue one. That's gonna change it on that side.
Yep. Let's press it again.
Okay.
Wait, back how days are or
my mind since I'm off joints. Okay, press the red one.
Press the red one, me? Do I press it?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. I press the red button.
Okay, good.
This is a VR one, Angel. This is next level. No resets. Unless you restart the whole world.
Are you just making noise next to me? You know how creepy that is.
I'll just sit here and wait.
Wait, there you are.
We're waiting, you guys. Let's have this time to talk. Just you and us, chat. Just you and us.
Press the blue button. Next.
I am pressing the blue button. Yes, such a limiting experience. But can we talk over the moving stone noises? Yes. Yeah, I think we can.
There's no jump in this world. I don't like it.
Moving stone noises. You're small. Very small.
Press the...
blue. But next, I'm orbs.
Oh! Oh, now your bubble scared me. Wow, thanks for that. Okay, so the lava is going that way right now, and I think it needs to be going towards the mask.
So
we gotta get towards the mask. The mask. Gotta get it to the mask. To the mask, the mask.
Need to press
10 hours later.
10 hours later.
Still churning sandstone rocks. Mints of Bay says, next, no! You can't just press random buttons. Everyone else does. Yeah. 3,000 years later. We're just like bones, just like ringer.
No, you can't just randomly push buttons. Stone scope. Why you give me a face?
Yeah. Oh, man, it's getting to me, man. We've been here forever. Forever, you guys. Forever. I'm not dead yet. Still got some life in me. Sheesh.
Damn it.
Is that cheeseburger I smell? Where'd you get that? I need some.
I'm gonna rotate like one of these. Can I like press one on the other side?
Yeah. Yeah, we gotta. So we gotta rotate this one, I think.
Why do you have that face?
Hold on, let me go here.
It's one of those very, very, very rare scenarios when a small person.
Pearlborn says it would be easier if everyone else was dead. I could just put your corpses on the button areas so they would just activate running and pressing on them. Okay. Lovely. Well,
do you have any other worlds that you gotta showcase? How do I think of it?
No, I can still showcase out this world. It's just like, if this puzzle is too hard for us to solve, we can just skip it. We can skip this part of the puzzle.
That'd be spoilers. Should we just save it for our users too?
Okay, I mean, actually, chat, you can decide. You can decide if we want to go on to the next world or if you want us to, you know. So, chat, type in if you want to see more inside of here. Pearl says, don't cheat. That would be spoilers. Yes. Dosh, NZ, thank you for the follow. I'm sure this is completely solvable, but we have to align up this, and we don't have the type of collaboration right now to be trying to do that. So, yeah. But it is an amazing world, and there's a lot more to it than just this, I promise you. There's a bunch of cool stuff that they've done out with this world, and definitely is a world worth checking out, I promise you that. So come in here with other friends and try to figure it out and try to play through it. It's pretty awesome.
Do you think you're big brain enough to do this? Try it now in Neos.
Yeah, and don't fly through it, obviously, or something like that.
You can't.
Angel says, "Nah, this puzzle is so easy." Brain. Fair enough, Angel. I'm sure we could get through if I had form of collaboration.
Shut up and get in here, then.
Yeah, Angel, why don't you get in here? Okay, let me get back in my other character and we'll go to the next world for you guys. But again, this world is called, let me bring it back up, Maze Chapter 1, and this is by, where is the user world's
name? Amazing.
Innocent Thief. And from what I hear, he's also going to be making some additional maze worlds that will be done out inside of Neos. So look out for some even better ones that he's planning on making in the future. But this one already is really awesome. There's like three or four other things that you can do throughout this maze that are really cool puzzles. And they're pretty hard and really awesome, I think. Dosh and Z says, didn't realize you guys streamed your own game. Yep, we stream now. We've been actually, I think we've been streaming like since like, I don't know, it's like been, what, 8 months now? 8 months since you've been streaming?
It's been a while.
Yeah, like, yeah.
And a couple other times before that, too, I remember.
Yeah, like Vision, really.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the last world that we're going to be showcasing out for the day is going to be the chess room. And this one is done by Cal and Zane, I'm guessing. And I'm going to start a new session. Really? My gosh, man.
Geico presents. Oh, not again. Another voicemail from your roommate.
Hey man, so I was in a
rush. Oh no, it's Geico.
I left the back door open. Shut it. I left it wide open.
Dang, radio's doing Geico commercials, I swear.
And all of them. My mom never let me use the oven. I wonder why.
The Geico insurance agency could help keep your personal property protected, like if it's your roommate's first time operating
okay,
an oven.
Okay. We don't care.
Where
were we? But yeah, the world time loads are very quick. So this world is pretty interesting. At least it's not the GTA 4 radio. Yeah. Moon's basically like, sorry, you guys, be right back. I gotta buy a car insurance. Yeah. So immediately in this world, you have a session spawner for active sessions. You also have a mirror right here. And inside of here, the main area. I don't know why that's selected out. Let me deselect it. Let me deselect.
No, next. I don't want to play chess with you because I'll lose now.
Oh, no. We're not going to probably play chess. I'm just showing off the world. So right up here, we can actually have now like a chess tournament if we so wanted to. So actually start moving some pieces around, you guys, so they can see it up on the board. Try to move some pieces around on the board.
It's
tied. See?
Oh, wow.
So you can see that they're actually snapping and they make the sound effect.
This is not how you play the game.
Oh yeah? King me.
Just kidding. And you can see them changing all real time up there on that top board.
That was a way for Fruits to add physics so we could flip the tables over.
So you can have like a really good... Yeah, illegal moves, you guys. The chat is being very triggered right now by these illegal...
Oh, yeah?
That was pretty illegal.
You want to see? You want to see illegal? Give me the table.
That's.
Fruits,
this is what I have
snacks,
to deal with. I have to deal with babies. These are babies. Wow.
got exploded. Wow.
You've been kinked.
So, a really cool world because you can, you know, play a game of chess and cipher. There's also a bunch of different chess tables around here. If you're a fan of chess, then this is definitely a really awesome world for you, as well as that radio sometimes plays some pretty decent music when it's not doing Geico commercials.
I tried legitimately placing the piece on the board and it went right to his tooltip.
Is this Yugi or something?
It's the duel.
Yeah, oh gosh. No, we already covered that for the
it's time
to the cross universe area. So. Yeah, the cat herding stream, basically.
I already played illegal chess. It's called.
Chess being spicy today. Very spicy.
What are you doing?
Oh my god, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Hello, Gordon.
Chat, explode him. Get him next.
No, don't.
His name is Bean.
Look at my cool chess sword.
Wow, you actually made a chess sword, my dude. The legend. The legend is true. We speak of the explosion of the Mad Max, as well as the sword of the holy powerful being. Karma indeed. Energy.
I got karma. You want karma? I got you karma.
You're just gonna do it yourself, aren't you? That's just...
No, you can explode him. You can definitely explode him. It's just set on a timer. Explosions are set to a specific timer. I think they're like a 30-second timer for an explosion. So you can't spam it. Isn't that right, Frox?
There's a timeout.
The music scares my ass.
Your measly little tricks didn't help. Your demise.
Yes, plus 5 to intellect on that chess sword. Probably, I would say with that chess sword, it's probably plus 10. Definitely plus 10. Is that, oh wait, no, that one's plus 5. It's pretty short. Just cries in a corner, just like, I will not be anything.
Where's the backpack?
Plus 50, nerd. Minus 10 aesthetics. Plus 50, nerd. My gosh. Savage. Savage angel. Oh, and there goes Bean. He exploded.
How dare you?
I had faith in you, chat. I had faith in you.
Yes.
I have faith in you,
yes, my equipment. Thank you.
Yep, explode is for sub only. Sorry about that, you guys. Otherwise, it would be used way too much. Yeah, and that's only for, like, the rare times that you do. Actually, we still need to bring in, when we make the new Twitch Streamer House, that's actually a good topping point to also talk about for you guys. The new Twitch Streamer House is going to have a Zeus effect, and it's actually going to be able to strike us down with lightning as well. So if ever you want to strike us down with lightning and Zeus us, we'll have that as a new Twitch chat command for the new Twitch Streamer House. And as well as, obviously, we're continually working very hard on getting in the new facet system. Frox has been working tirelessly to continue out to build out that, which we're very grateful for. He works very hard on being able to set that up for us so then we can have an amazing new UI that's coming in very, very soon. And yes, you guys will be getting that nice Zeus effect. We just have to build out once we have free time. Yeah, and the head pat boop. Yes, we will get that as well, Renari. Promise. We will have that. The shrink is a maybe.
Wait.
That's a maybe.
Am I?
Yes,
I am. Okay, good.
You'll never win me a chess.
So we're going to be able to have that set up. And I just want to thank you guys again for joining us for this Twitch stream, showing off all the cool content here that's in different worlds there inside of Neos. We're also going to take this time to also spawn out a few items that we know that were made out inside of this time of May. And we're going to be showing that off on the stream for the next 10 minutes, and then we're going to be ending off the stream. Also, if you guys have any questions in the chat, please be sure to like leave any questions here. And we would be more than happy to answer any questions for you guys. And again, just want to give a big thank you for all of our supporters, people that have supported us on Patreon, people that are supporting us on our Discord, people that are supporting us on in all these different ways that we're so grateful, because it's you guys that are allowing us to continue out this sort of awesome project to be basically make out the internet VR in a way, a metaverse, a virtual place that anyone can come into and then they can socialize and create within it. And yeah, I'm just so excited to get more going for this platform, and it's all thanks to you guys. So again, thank you for helping us and supporting us in this way. And thank you just for being here and just checking out what we're doing on the stream. Angel says, I have a serious question next. How come that you are so adorable? Okay. Yeah, so this thanks. Yes. And yep, no problem, Moonsun babies. Or Monsoon baby, sorry.
Why does your head say awkward?
Did you show the M4A1 from Counter-Strike 1.6 I made? Thanks. Gory has a copy of it. Let me see. M4A.
This one.
We kind of modified it, though, so the sounds are...
Oh, so this is the... Oh, yeah, for sure. The item showcase. Why not?
There we go.
Oh, my gosh. It fires me back. Ooh. Here, wait.
Could this be a meme format?
How do I reload this?
Remove the cartridge. Okay.
Nice.
Did you see Nex's face when he started shooting? Look at his face.
I know, right?
He's tryharding to shoot.
die. It actually kills people. I love it. Ooh.
You can remove the silence.
I don't have any more bullets.
I trust you.
Oh.
That works.
Wow. He just literally launched me into the roof. This, I love this, and I'm saving this gun. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, you can remove that? Sick.
Shoot again.
Oh, I love that.
Okay, now put down the weapon.
That is fucking cool.
Yes.
Sorry for cursing.
No.
Are you kidding me? Can you respawn out the gun?
There it is. He's gone.
I don't know why the boot dead.
Can you respawn out the gun so I can save it?
Sorry.
Boom, 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 boom.
Oh, I was on the call. There.
Gory, respawn out the gun, because it got deleted. Thanks. Yes, for next, say hello to my little friend. Yeah. Here, I can do that.
Watch out of the way, so he doesn't shoot you guys.
Say hello to my little friend! And they shoot everyone. Yep. That's what happened.
Something is compensating for if you see a little friend.
Yep. What a wonderful item made for May. I love it. Let's show off some other cool stuff as well.
I'm sure, in a different world, maybe.
Okay. Oh, it's fine to show us over here, because we're probably gonna be ending off the stream pretty soon.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Are you showing UI stuff, boy?
I'll just spawn.
Mega, hello to you. Welcome. We're ending off the stream though pretty soon. We just got done showing off all of the cool content here of different worlds made out for the month of May of Neos, as well as now we're just showing off at the end of the stream just a few items and objects that were made out for this month. Mega says, "What kind of Twitch streamer are you?" I am just somebody who's streaming out the platform that I love, and that's Neos VR. And I would say that, just kind of like, I guess sometimes educational, sometimes just recreational, just for fun.
Wait.
Yeah, I guess you could say that. Yeah. That I is.
Wait,
quite a few people are inside of this. Yeah, I'm a magical Evoli.
Oh no.
I'll make all your dreams happen.
Oh no, I know what you're doing. Wait, I actually have a better idea. Hold on.
Oh, thank you for the follow, Mega. Will says, Neos VR, is it possible for Neos to show clips? Yeah, you can show clips. Yeah. Oh, well, thank you for that, Mega. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I guess in a regard, yeah. Kinda. I mean, I even have my own puppet. Like, I mean, come on.
Like,
once you have your own puppet, you've made it in life. You know what I mean? But this is definitely not me.
This meme is only for intellectuals.
So let's show out some stuff. Gearbell has actually made out a nice little fireplace. We'll show off that. So with this fireplace, let me bring the camera down a little bit. There you guys go. And we'll put the fireplace right here. What's cool about this one is we can actually grab onto the sticks and we can light whatever object that we want on fire. So what would we like to do?
I will volunteer.
Mega says the number two way for me to automatically follow and host is if you're a furry Twitch streamer at Neos VR. Oh, well, cool. I'm glad that you like. I mean, I wouldn't say that that's our direct content, though. I wouldn't say that that's just like the main thing. I would say the main thing is it's for Neos. It's a Neos stream. It's to show out Neos as a platform. And,
oh, there it is.
Yeah.
I got it. Look.
Yes. Yep. I'm roasting.
So. Yep, let me... Oh, you're seeing... Oh, I'm sorry, I was hitting your display. Sorry about that. So right here, I have a piece, a chest piece, and I'm going to light it on fire. And obviously, yeah, you can use this with any, you know, any item and object. And just, you know, like, just roast a little bit of stuff, you know? Whether it be whatever you want in your life, you know, anything. Anything that you need to light on fire.
No.
Just go right ahead.
Come on, Guri, get on the stick. Come on, Guri, get on the stick. Get on the stick.
They posted in the chat.
Yeah.
Take a look.
What's this?
That is the clip they posted in the chat.
Dude.
Say hello to my little friend.
I love it.
Wait, say hello to my little friend. Say hello to my little friend.
That is a great clip. Thank you, you guys, for producing that so quick.
Not gonna lie.
Oh, yes. Oh, wow. You actually lit on fire now. Wow. It's blowing up on Reddit. Shit. Good.
Yeah.
Fire.
Wait, you're gonna roast your inventory?
Damn, I'm lit. Litty lit. Litty McLitty.
Wait, can we light up the camera?
Yeah, we can light up the camera. Here, wait. Let me set it to manual.
Light up chat.
Okay, here. Light so we're gonna light selfie stick. Hey, selfie sticky guys. Hey.
We're gonna light up. We're all getting roasted.
Oh my gosh. Here, wait. Let me actually move the. Let me look. The camera is like. Here, wait. I feel like we can like zoom it out more. Or like you could. Oh my gosh.
You can. Wait,
I just gotta like bring the stick like a little bit more back. I don't know. Hi, you guys. Right. Here, maybe this might be a little bit better. Oh, yeah, there we go. Somewhat. It's kind of hard just for you. Burn! 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 Woo! Woo! That's selfie stick mode, right?
This is what I think of the clip.
Yeah, that's hot.
There you guys go.
That's hot.
That's hot.
Yeah.
Oh, that's hot.
That's hot. Oh, no, he's
2017 he's called, they want their selfie sticks back. Hey, these are patent pending. Yeah, these are just straight from nature. They don't cost a single dime. And you can just glue them onto your phone. They're pretty great. Patent pending. Wilderness. Yeah, but they're patent pending. Oh I put God, a patent yes. on them. The nature selfie stick. Patent pending.
My gun agrees with this logic.
I'll burn the mirror.
Wait, hold on. Turn it on so everyone can see it.
Yeah. Here. Let's get you guys off of this stick. There we go.
Incendiary ammo.
You're looking good, Frox. Looking real good.
Oh, there you go. It's like a selfie mirror.
Come on.
Now I got a selfie mirror.
Everyone can see you, Frox.
What?
They can all see you. Aw.
There you go. Selfie mirror.
Okay. Thank you very much.
I said selfie mirror on the stick.
Oh, sorry.
Really well,
here, wait, let me try to turn it off. Thanks.
What if we barbecue?
Can you put Frox on a stick? Hey Frox. They want you on a stick. Chat has ordained it. They did say that they want you on a stick, boy. Poor Frox.
This is cursed.
Okay. We'll put him on a stick. Okay. So how are we gonna put him on a stick, though?
I got it.
We can pause.
Yeah. Do you have that? Do you have that ring? Where's that ring model? Oh, I see. We got the puppet. There. Yeah, that works too. Here. Yeah. Let's. Thank you very much,
No.
Oh my god. Here, wait. Frox, can you sit on this?
Oh.
Gory, shoot, boy. Gory, yeah, sit on this right here. Okay, so we're gonna put Frox right there. Hello, Frox. Hello. Oh, don't worry. This only hurts a lot.
Hello.
Here, wait.
Oh, what?
Oh, where did you go, Frox? Oh, there we go. Here, wait, you gotta be careful. Hi. I don't know what the heck's going on. Hi. Okay, I'm trying to put the.
You gotta put it near the tip.
What do you think I'm trying to do?
Try harder.
That was not intentional.
That's because I'm wrong for giving.
You're an idiot.
I know.
I have to jump into it after.
Okay, oh yeah, now try to get into it.
That'd be good.
Oh, we got the Frox on the stick. Here, wait. Yo, don't worry, boy. Oh, hello, Frox. Oh, you look so cute.
Get ready to clip this.
Hello, Frox. I just wanted to warm you up, but I'm sorry. It's okay. Don't worry. Okay, we're good.
You love me. You really love me.
That's okay. He is okay, everyone. I put the fire out. Oh! He's not okay. He's not okay. He exploded. Oh my gosh. Alert, don't say that. My gosh.
This is how you burn your fans, literally.
Well, yeah. This has been an amazing day. What, dude?
Get back in that seat, boy.
Okay, we're getting rid of Mr. Fire now. No more fire.
Aw, but that was a fun part.
Yes, so that's inside of Gearbell's toy shop under the gadgets folder. That's something that's been made out for the month of May. As well as there's plenty of other stuff. There's also Turk also has made and redesigned our new effortless equipable tool, if you guys don't already know, which allows you to create whatever equipable items that you want inside Neo. So you can make hats, you can make bracelets, you can make anything that you would want to be equipable to any part of your body. You would use this device right here, and this is inside of the Neos Essentials in your inventory right here now. And this is Turk's updated version. So thank you again to Turk for updating that out this month. As well as if I missed anyone, obviously during the streams, I only have a certain amount of time that I can actually show out stuff. And if you ever want your stuff showed off on the stream, just let me know beforehand, because I do this every single month at the end of the month to basically show off the creations of you guys and show off this cool stuff, because there's always such cool content always being made by you guys, and I'm always happy to share it with the world. And I think the world should be able to see the cool stuff that you put your time in, you put your effort into and work on. So thank you for the people who do that. And yes, it is a pretty cool room. I love this room. Again, this room is done out by Cal, and it is called the chess room. So definitely check it out. Really great place to play chess. Also check out all the other places that we showcased out. Check out that maze room. Check out Cross Universe. Check out all these awesome things that are being done out at Neos right now. And there's going to be even so much more stuff down the line, you guys. Anyone who's getting into Neos right now, they're getting into the future, because it's basically just the beginning for it right now. It's just the beginning for Neos. And anyone who's in it, they're really benefiting to be able to benefit the most right now. So thank you again, you guys, and we'll say goodbye to everyone. Everyone, say goodbye. Au revoir. If you have any final questions, also just put them in chat. We'll do that. So, if not, though, we'll say au revoir.
You love me. You really like love me.
You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record, baby, right round, round, round. Oh boy. Boom, 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 boom. But yes, love you all. Have an awesome Friday. Enjoy your night or day, or maybe it might even be Saturday for you. You might live in on the other side of the world. That too. Yep, thank you, Angel. See ya. And thank you again also to Snooper for all those bits and the gifted subs. That was very kind of you. And everyone else who subbed as well and followed. Thank you for those follows as well. You guys are awesome. And join our Discord, please, everyone. Discord is great. And if you really enjoy Neos and you like what we're doing here, be sure to write us a review on Steam as well. That helps us out quite a bit as well. So if you can't help us monetarily wise, you can help us with a nice review if you enjoy Neos as a platform. So thank you again, you guys. Hey, Ninja, we're ending off the stream. Have an awesome Friday, my dude. But we'll put clips on our YouTube channel, and as well as we'll, you know, make clips of for future videos to highlight some video, hopefully.
You love me. You really love me.
Oh. Love you too, Renari.
You love me.
Love you as well.
You really love me.
Love you guys too. Bye bye. Okay. Peace to everyone.
Bye.